Drop the crabs on the tray, hit record on the sale, pop the cap, I got a story to tell.
Come on now.
What's up? Welcome back to I Got Crabs. Why do I say that? Because I got crabs. Plenty of them. Got 3 dozen. I should have got a bushel. Got 3 dozen from Captain Billy's. Now, before we get into that, today we're going to talk about, should we or should we not tell friends information about the relationships they're in? Should we do that? Man, that can be real tricky. Nevertheless, got the crabs from Billy's. They got regular and mediums mixed. Right now in Maryland, there's a surplus of crabs, but right now they're small. So by the time August, September rolls around, these crabs are going to be huge. So they got those off to the side doing their thing, growing and growing and growing. In the meantime, we're eating these regulars and mediums. And little t-shirt check, going into Wakanda, we got the Black Panther. We got the Black Panther doing their thing, Wakanda forever up in here. Our beer is brought to us by a friend on Facebook, my girl Kelly. What's up, Kelly? Thank you. She posted Blue Moon Mango Wheat and talked about how good it is, or delicious it is, or bomb it is. So I told her thanks, and I'm gonna try it out. I don't know if she knew I was gonna try it out on I Got Crabs, but it's here now. So just pop the cap. That intro was live from Bedford Stuyvesant from the lyrical book of Notorious B.I.G. Baby, baby, I got a story to tell. So, relationships. You got a friend. You know some information about his or her spouse or loved one or the person they're dating or a lover or prospective lover. Do you tell? Do you keep it to yourself? And for the sake of, you know, pronouns and proper nouns, her name is Tina. And my homeboy's name is David. So David tells me Tina's first name. He tells me this, he tells me that. They went out to lunch. She said this, she said that. He all up in it. I'm like, cool, I know what this is. I know what this is. I say, is her last name Brown? He said, yeah, how do you know? It's her birthday, May 12th. Yeah, wait a minute, what's going on, man? Did she go to such and such college? Yeah. Did she graduate in 2000? Yeah. Wait a minute, what's going on? I know her. Stop playing. Now, I done told him all this stuff about her. Do it look like I'm playing? Do I? So I tell him all this stuff about her, and he's still not sold. So finally he says, I say yes. Now, one thing I know about you, you don't like messing with women with kids. Now, kids are cool with me. I love kids. And in fact, I was dealing with a woman who had a kid at the time. And he said, nah, I don't mess with, yeah, you're right, I don't mess with women that have kids. And I said, well, guess what? The woman that you're talking about, she has a kid. No, she don't. She ain't got no kids. Did I say David? David, trust me. She has a kid. Not only does she have a kid, she has a 12-year-old kid. A daughter. No, she don't. All right, where does this girl you're talking about, where does she live? I said, she lived in such and such city. He said, oh no, it's a different woman because this woman lives in blank. Mind you, these cities are connected. They're right next to each other. Turns out that she moved within the 2 years that I've met her. Down the road, probably not even a mile, maybe a mile and a half down the road. So I said, okay, just be careful. I know what I'm doing. Now, among the things I asked about her, you know, I said, was her birthday this, her last name this, did she graduate this year, blah, 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 blah. But one thing that stood out is that she was a big Bobby Womack fan. Now, what is a young girl doing being a big fan of Bobby Womack? Red flag. Now, I told him, I'm telling y'all, they say a man or a woman will walk out of your life if you buy them some shoes. I say a man or woman will run rings around you if they like Bobby Womack and the blues. And that's what I say. He ain't want to hear me. 6 months go by. Now he calls me up. He wants to talk. Where you at? I want to stop over there, man. I got something I want to talk to you about. Stops by my apartment. Proceeds to tell me, yo, man, I think Tina got a daughter. Oh, yeah? Tell me about her. How old is she? 14? Yeah, I think she got a 14-year-old daughter, man. Same ain't right. She said she had a little sister, but I found out her mother is 71. Now, how's a 71-year-old gonna have a 14-year-old baby unless she's, you know, she's taking it off from another relative or something? And I said, I gave him that look, like when the police pull up, and you look around, you see that one white dude like this? That's how I was looking the whole time we were talking. Because I told him. I told him everything. So, he stays with her a little while longer. Tell me he gonna investigate more and find out about this girl that she keeps saying is her cousin slash little sister. And that's how she got caught out there. One minute, she said the 14-year-old was her little sister. The next minute, she said it was a little cousin. She kept getting mixed up. I kept telling him in my head, because I never say anything else verbally. I'm like, it's neither. It's her daughter, dum-dum. So, at the six-month mark, he's crying. He's all sad. Yeah, man, you lying, man. You got a daughter, man. You can't trust these girls, man. I'm telling you, man. You can't trust. You ain't had to trust her. You just trust my word for it. She had a daughter, like I said. I said she was 12. That was 2 years earlier. She's 14 now. Dumb, dumb. So, he's upset, and he's harassing her. He wants the iPad back that he bought her, or the tablet, whatever it was. He bought her a phone and this and that. I'm like, look, we boys and everything. I gave you a warning. You should have gave me. You should have upgraded my phone for me giving you that information that could have saved you all this money. Took on a vacation, paid for this and that. She ran circles around dude. Not only did she get in his pockets, but she messed him up mentally. Scarred him. She was out of his league. Now, I knew what I was dealing with when I caught her. And a couple of lies the day I met her. The day I met her was the last day I dealt with her. Double date. My homeboy was going out with this woman. He said, you know what? You should hook up with such and such. That's a homegirl. I said, yeah? Yeah. So I got with her, talked to her. Saw right through her. First of all, when I walked in the door, I had that Bobby Womack clam. Saying to myself, hey, her mother up in here having a good time. Because my grandparents used to listen to Bobby Womack and Down Home Blues. And they be sitting back there. My grandparents with their Hennessy cups. Yo, Bacardi rum. And Garney on the Down Home Blues. Everybody there drinking, getting lit. So, I'm thinking her parents are doing the same thing. I get up in there and it turns out it's her. We walk up into her house, into this little dining area. It's just her listening to it. She tells me how much she loves Bobby Womack. Red flag. I see how old her mother is. 12-year-old sister. Red flag. How are you in your late 20s and you got a 12-year-old little sister with no siblings in between and your parents are really retired and they up there in age? I ain't going for it. Now, you know how you can avoid being taken advantage of? If when you see the red flags, you bail out from the get-go. Say for example, y'all chilling. You meet somebody, y'all digging each other, y'all go out on a date. Nighttime, y'all go out to dinner or a movie or whatever. The bar to get some drinks, going to a club, and y'all walk out in the street, arm in arm, and he or she says, wait a minute, come on, let's go down here. And you turn, and it's a dark alley. A naive person would be like, you know what? I'm feeling this. Everything was going right. We cool. I'm going in that alley. Yeah, it's all right. I say, I ain't going down that alley. It's dark. I'm trying to get some heat. What's down there? Oh no, it's dangerous down there. Forget that. That's what I did when I met her. I saw the game. I'm not a player. I just look a lot. And she knew I saw the game. So when we departed that night, that was it. No rubby-dubby. No lovey-dubby. No kissing, no nothing. But some talking. Over some Bobby Womack. And me getting up out of there. And now my homeboy comes 2 years later. Fell in love with her. Wasn't listening when I gave him the warning signals. Matter of fact, I ain't give him a warning signal. I ain't give him a red flag. I told him. She got a daughter, you don't like kids. Back up. It's not for you. So, he all heartbroken, blah, 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 blah. Then he calls me up and said, hey, I need you to meet me somewhere. Now this is where he really got me messed up. Gave me the address back when I had my motorcycle. I rolled up on the address. He invites me inside. I go inside. Stand in the living room. And the living room is next to the dining room. And both of them have these long wall of mirrors. All right, Kels. All right, Kelly. I like your beer. Your Blue Moon. Mango Wheat. Props to Kelly. I told her I was going to try it. She posted it. So big ups to her. Big ups to This Is Me, Hated to Love It. So I go inside. You got these mirrors. He goes into the dining room and he starts talking. So I'm listening, I'm like, wait a minute. I look over in the mirrors and it's the girl, it's Tina. Or Trina, whatever her name was. This knucklehead took me to her job. So I could see if I recognized her as a woman that I was telling him about months ago. So when I leave, I ask him, I say, yeah, you tell her about me? He's like, yeah, well, you know, I told her, I said, yeah, I want you to meet my boy Marlon, you know, meet my boy Marlon, see if you recognize him. Or he said he might know you. So now he put me out there. I looked out for him,
Now he's going to tell her, blah, 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 blah. And I mean, she put two and two together and realized it was me that told me she had a child. And while I was in there, looking in there, I looked in the mirror and saw it was her. She looked back at me in the mirror, and we locked eyes, and she's like, give me a look like, what's going on? And why are you hanging with this dude? And I'm thinking to myself, I don't even know why I'm hanging with this dude. I try to put him up on game, and he, this what he does? Man. So, which brings me to the current year. He met this woman, fell in love, real nice girl too. But I got major stuff on her. Major, much bigger than her having a child. Much bigger, something that would really hurt his feelings. Guess what? I ain't tell him nothing. And I'm not gonna tell him nothing. Because of how he burned that bridge back then. Nope, nope, nope. My information is my information. I'm not telling you, your mama, your preacher, none of y'all gonna get what I know. I'm gonna keep it to myself. And that woman, she gonna wink her eye, look away. Whatever she does, she doesn't have to worry about me saying anything. Keep my mouth shut. Right, that's it. So, sometimes you can tell things and get good results. The person can, you know, use that information and put it to use. Sometimes you can tell it to a sucker and they mess you over. And I'll put your name out there. So, these crabs are the bomb. These crabs, I'm gonna rate these like a 9, 9.5, probably a 10. And this beer is a bomb. I didn't think I was gonna like it, it said mango. I'm not a big mango fan. I love fresh fruit, I'm not a big mango person. But everything is a bomb. I can eat these crabs without dipping them. That's how good they are. But I'm gonna holler back at y'all tomorrow with another episode of I Got Crabs. And if your friends, relatives, or somebody cares about you, tries to give you information on the person you're dating, take it. Tuck it somewhere or keep it in the back of your mind. Analyze it. Whatever you do, don't say nothing, because that's equivalent to snitching. Just met her, ain't gonna tell her about my boy Marvin. Hey, get out of here, man. I'll smack him in his head next time I see him. I'm out.